This is an art attack. This is an art attack. This is art attack. Welcome to Art Attack. Now, don't worry, I haven't gone mad. I'm just trying something out. All will be revealed. Come and have a look at this. Snail tracks. Now, I'm sure you've seen them on the pavement. They're marks snails leave behind them wherever they go. So I guess this is a picture of a day in the life of a snail. Now, can you imagine what it would be like if us humans left human snail marks behind us wherever we went? What would a day in your life look like? Well, OK, let's imagine that you leave green human snail marks behind you. So there you are, you're at home, you leave home, and you start to walk to school. You arrive at school, and you spend all day marching up and down the corridors and in the classrooms. And then in the afternoon, you get on the school bus, you go to the playing field, you run three times around the playing field, and then you stagger home at the end of the day, because you're exhausted. And there it is, a day in your life. Now, what about your dad? Let's imagine he leaves blue marks behind him wherever he goes. So, OK, your dad leaves home in the morning and he walks to the station. Yes. And he arrives at the station and he gets on his train. The train goes round all the way to his office. And when he's in his office, he's scurrying round all day. He's busy every day. Around the filing cabinets, and the telephones. And at the end of his day, he gets on the bus, probably because there's a train strike, and he goes all the way home. And that's his day. And what about your mum? Well, let's give her red marks. Let's imagine she leaves red marks. So she leaves home, and she gets into her trusty old car. She goes into town in her car, and she arrives at the car park. She drives around the car park three or four times because she can't find a parking space, and she gets her car parked, and off she goes to the shops. If your mum's anything like my mum, you spend loads of time in the shops, window shopping, browsing around, buying stuff. Not for me, unfortunately. And she goes back to her car and gets lost on the way home. And there it is, a day in the life of your family. So try it for yourself. Give each member of your family a different colour. What does a day in the life of your family look like?
Good idea, eh? Tracing your movements and turning it into a work of art. I traced my movements yesterday, came up with this. Well, what did you expect?
Oh, it's getting rather chilly in here. Duncan Hamilton is having a frozen heart attack. remember me? I'm Sherlock Bones. 5 weeks ago, I was a sheet of blank paper, and today I'm going to get a proper voice and be turned into a real moving cartoon character. Not bad at all, eh? But before you can do anything with your cartoon character, you have to know what he looks like from all angles. And to help you do this, this is a great idea. Draw the face of your cartoon character onto an egg. Now, that's Sherlock Bones there. And as you can see, if you turn the egg around, you can see him from different angles, and it helps you draw different aspects of him. I've also done one of what's up here. There he is. And he's got a slightly more rounded face. So I've done him on a ping pong ball. And again, you can turn him around from different angles and see what he looks like. You can go one step further. You can actually create a model out of modeling clay there. Just paint it all up, and that will help you look at the body from all angles as well. And there he is, good old Bones. So when you really do know your cartoon character, how's about giving him a voice? Well, you can have great fun trying different voices out for your character. There he is. But I'm actually not going to. I'm going to leave this one to the expert.
It's me, Gilbert. Come on, let me in.
Don't worry. It's not Green Gilbert. Yes. It is, in fact, the voice behind Gilbert, Phil Cornwell.
Hello,
hiya, Phil.
Sir. Hello there.
How you doing?
All right. All
good.
Right, yeah.
You know this character, then?
I do. Intimately.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Now, I asked you to provide the voice for Sherlock Bones for me. How did you do?
Well, I looked at the drawing initially, and it sort of struck me immediately what sort of voice this character would have, fortunately, because it's just... you want to hear the voice?
I certainly do.
Well, I saw it, and I thought, I say, my name's Sherlock Bones, actually, and it's based on an old character actor called Terry Thomas, who's brilliant. He used to be a very famous actor.
It's really weird to hear that, because that's the first time I've heard the character done properly. I mean, I've been trying it, but you've really hit it on the head there.
Yeah, yeah. Well, the thing is, it's sort of... with this one, it struck me immediately, just because of his manner, you know, just looking at him. So that was no problem.
OK, what about his assistant, then? What's up?
Well, with him, again, I thought I looked at the drawing and wasn't quite as obvious to me.
Right.
But eventually, I've settled on a sort of... excuse me, sir. My name's WhatsApp, actually. He's just a little bit more apologetic. But, in fact, he's the one with the brains.
Now, that's a good contrast, isn't it? Because
yes.
He's meek and mild, and the other fellow's very flamboyant and proud, and, as you say, all puffed up.
Got to have that, yeah. It's basics, really. Get the contrast.
All right, well,
thanks. It'll work, hopefully. Yeah.
All right, well, we'll soon find out, then. Can you do the two of them together?
Of course, OK.
All right, then.
I say, I do sound good. What about you? I sound good, too. I hear we're going to be animated next week. What's that? Made into a cartoon? Exactly!
My name's Bobby and I based this puppet on an old man called Frederick.
My name's Vicky and I based this on a mad nurse.
My name's Claire and I based this puppet on my mum.
Very, very nice. But they're sort of squidgy, aren't they? Not like us. How are they made, then?
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Well, you take one stick.
You mean one 70-centimetre length of this dowling?
Exactly. Then you
And you stick it through the middle of a 26-centimetre kitchen roll-style cardboard tube and up through a cardboard cone.
Made simply from a semicircle.
Exactly. Made simply from a semicircle of cardboard. And you stick some tape round the top of the stick and pull it down so it wedges the cone nice and tight into the tube-like. Then fold a piece of felt in half, sew it up and turn it inside out and put it on top of the cone.
Yes, of course you do. But also, you put some stuffing inside the felt.
Of course you do. Then you make features like noses, lips and eyes out of stuffing and pin them on.
And then you cover the whole lot with an old stocking or tights and pick out the features with stitching to give that attractive, squidgy look.
Mind you, she, if she is a she, still needs a bit of work.
Not like us.
Not like us. But they don't make them like us anymore, do they?
We'll be right back. apples and oranges. Get your lovely apples and oranges here, then. Come on, missus, get your lovely apples and oranges. God, no customers today. I know what I'll do. Right, then. Lovely parrots here. Have trouble drawing people? Well, you could always stick to the good old-fashioned stick man. Nah, that's not very good. If you want to draw something a bit more realistic, that's where this lot comes in. A pound of sausages. Now, don't laugh, it does help, because if you think of each part of the body as a sausage, then it helps with your drawing. There's a head, and there's a body. Now we bring in two sausages for each of the legs. One, here. Two sausages there, the other leg, and then the arms, you got two sausages, the other arm there. It's beginning to look a bit more chunky already, isn't it? If I just move that out of the way, you can see that it really does work when your man starts to move. Okay, let's draw him running. There he is. Two sausages for the arms again. Two sausages for each of the legs. Of course, you can't put the feet in. Or how's about jumping? Two sausages for the arms. Big one for the body there. Two for the legs again. Jumping off into the air. And don't forget his feet. There we are. A vast improvement. I think I'll have him for me tea later on.
If you'd like the facts on today's art attacks, send for your artifacts to me, the head. P.O. Box 123, Southampton SO9 7HH. P.O. Box 123, Southampton SO9 7HH.
You know, I reckon you can make an art attack out of almost anything. Like an old piece of packing tape. Well, I'll give it a go. See you next week.